Firefighters were able to prevent the flames from doing any major damage to a large addition, which was completed approximately 2 years ago at a cost of more than $3 million. However, there was some damage to that unit in the front, and smoke, water, and heat damage was extensive throughout. The main portion of the Civic Center, which was built 18 years ago, has been destroyed. Arriving firemen from Salisbury's number one and number two companies said the flames had spread from one end of the building to the other, and by that time they were unable to even approach close enough for effective firefighting because of instructions on the flammable liquid, and had opened all doors and windows and had all of the ventilating fans in the roof turned on. They said they had used the same method of stripping the floor several times before without incident. There were almost 100 children between the ages of 8 to 12 in two separate classes in the recreation complex. One was a children's theater group rehearsing for an upcoming production, and the other was a recreation and parts department arts and crafts class because of the intense heat from the blaze. Some firemen were required to use their hoses to wet down their own personnel and equipment who had pulled up too close to the building when they first arrived. Several times, sparks were picked up by the heavy draft caused by the flames and endangered nearby homes, a shirt factory directly behind the Civic Center, and the massive Salisbury Mall shopping complex just across the road. Some witnesses said they could see the dense black clouds of smoke from as far away as Princess Anne, 15 miles to the south, and well up into Delaware to the north. Salisbury Deputy Fire... A massive traffic jam developed in the eastern suburbs of the city. Bill Taylor, who was in charge of the firefighters, called for assistance from fire companies in Delmar, Fruitland, Hebron, Parsonsburg, and Powellville in Maryland, and from Maine. Salisbury City Police officers, Maryland State Police, and Wicomico County Sheriff's officers were all called as curious onlookers tried to get to the scene. Green said his five-man crew had spread the highly inflammable stripper on the floor, and they were in the process of running a floor polishing machine with a pad on it over the stripper when it burst in flame. It is assumed that a spark from the buffing machine ignited the fumes from the flammable stripper. Civic Center personnel said they had complied. Personnel sounded the alarm as the flames spread rapidly throughout the large building, and all of the children were evacuated promptly and suffered no injuries. Firefighters were able to prevent the flames from doing any major damage to a large addition, which was completed approximately 2 years ago at a cost of more than $3 million. However, there was some damage to that unit in the front, and smoke, water, and heat damage was extensive throughout. The main portion of the Civic Center, which was built 18 years ago, has been destroyed. Arriving firemen from Salisbury's number one and number two companies said the flames had spread from one end of the building to the other, and by that time they were unable to even approach close enough for effective firefighting because of the intense heat from the blaze. Some firemen were required to use their hoses to wet down their own personnel and equipment who had pulled up too close to the building when they first arrived. Several times, sparks were picked up by the heavy draft caused by the flames and endangered nearby homes, a shirt factory directly behind the Civic Center, and the massive Salisbury Mall shopping complex just across the road. Some witnesses said they could see the dense black clouds of smoke from as far away as Princess Anne, 15 miles to the south, and well up into Delaware to the north. Salisbury Deputy Fire Chief Bill Taylor, who was in charge of the firefighters, called for assistance from fire companies in Delmar, Fruitland, Hebron, Parsonsburg, and Powellville in Maryland, and from Laurel, Delaware. A massive traffic jam developed in the eastern suburbs of the city as curious onlookers tried to get to the scene. Salisbury City Police officers, Maryland State Police, and Wicomico County Sheriff's officers were all called on to control the traffic around the scene. This is Jim Brown, WBOC News.